President Trump actually inherited the worst fiscal situation of any, and don't get mad at me because I haven't finished the sentence, but of any president other than Truman. Now, I did say that once, and people got furious because it somehow was as though I was saying that came from President Obama, which could not be farther from the truth. President Obama inherited one of the worst economic situations of any president and had to deal with this whole situation that had been put forth in front of the administration and took so much time, energy, and hard work. And sort of one of the lessons is presidents come into office with a whole agenda of things they want to do and also an agenda of things they have to do because it is there in front of them. And this president walked into a situation where the debt, because of many choices made before, is twice the historical average at 77% of GDP. But the last time that it was higher than this was right after World War II. And then it was projected and did go down very rapidly as the economy grew and we were able to recover from that. This time, it's projected to grow massively over the coming years and at the end of the decade be somewhere between slightly below, slightly above 100% of GDP. So we are about to have trillion-dollar deficits starting in about 2 years, coming back for every year, forever. We're about to have a debt that will be as big as the entire economy. And one real warning signal is that interest payments in the federal budget are the fastest growing part of the budget. So we'll get to why you worry about this, but this could not be a worse prescription for what we need in this country. What we need is a comprehensive economic growth plan that figures out how you grow the economy and do so in a way that works for a lot of the citizens. Having a huge overhang of debt is a real drag on being able to do that.